grace of our Lord Jesus Christ and the love of God and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with all of you.
And with your spirit.
My brothers and sisters, let us acknowledge our sins so as to prepare ourselves to celebrate the sacred mysteries. I confess to Almighty God and to you, my brothers and sisters, that I have greatly sinned in my thoughts and in my words, in what I have done and what I have failed to do, through my fault, through my fault, through my most grievous fault. Therefore, I ask Blessed Mary, ever Virgin, all the angels and saints, and you, my brothers and sisters, to pray for me to the Lord our God. May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Glory to God in the highest, and on earth peace to people of goodwill. We praise you, we bless you, we glorify you. We give you thanks for your great glory, Lord God, heavenly King, O God, almighty Father. Lord Jesus Christ, only begotten Son, Lord God, Lamb of God, Son of the Father, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. You take away the sins of the world, receive our prayer. You are seated at the right hand of the Father, have mercy on us. For you alone are the Holy One, you alone are the Lord, you alone are the Most High, Jesus Christ, with the Holy Spirit, in the glory of God the Father. Amen. Let us pray. Grant, Lord, we pray, that we may imitate what we worship, and so learn to love even our enemies, for we celebrate the heavenly birthday of a man who knew how to pray even for his persecutors. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever. Amen. Amen.
A reading from the Acts of the Apostles. Stephen, filled with grace and power, was working great wonders and signs among the people. Certain members of the so-called synagogue of freedmen, Cyrenians and Alexandrians, and people from Cilicia and Asia, came forward.
of men, for they will hand you over to courts and scourge you in their synagogues, and you will be led before governors and kings for my sake, as a witness before them and the pagans. When they hand you over, do not worry about what you are to speak or what you are to say. You will be given at that moment what you are to say, for it will not be you who speak, but the Spirit of your Father speaking through you. Brother will hand over brother to death, and the father his child. Children will rise up against parents and have them put to death. You will be hated by all because of my name, but whoever endures to the end will be saved. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
But whoever endures to the end will be saved. What a beautiful time of the year. It is about salvation and being saved by Him, the Christ, who has come into this world, the God who has no time, who is timeless, that is born into time. By His love and His generosity, may you and I see that wholeheartedly. You know, the church gives us 8 days of Christmas. It's called the octave. In 8 days, we celebrate Christmas Day. It gives us a chance to just this step back for a moment and to breathe and take all of this in. You know, the mystery of our faith is so intense that we need just to breathe it in and to allow the mystery to take effect in our life. The mystery of the incarnation, the Word becoming flesh and dwelling among us, the innocence and the humility of a baby. The thoughts of many, is this real? Is this what God intends? Is this how God is to save His people? How He was born in poverty? And even in the humility of the birth setting. It calls for faith, doesn't it? And you and I gather on this day in which we remember Saint Stephen, the first martyr for the faith. We look to Stephen as a witness to all of us, especially in this Christmas octave. The red is symbolic of that of giving one's life over to God. And Stephen has certainly done that. Being a martyr for the faith and shedding your blood is a very powerful statement. But you and I will continue to give our lives to Christ, maybe not by the shedding of our blood, but always to be faithful to Him to the end. You will be hated by all because of my name, but whoever endures to the end will be saved. God's Spirit is living and breathing in us, even despite the very many obstacles that are presented to us each day, and the sort of deaths we must undergo to resist sin and to make sure that we're daily converted to God. Sometimes that is extremely difficult, and you feel the pangs of death when you do resist sin because of the immensity of the struggle. But Christ calls us to endure to the end because the Spirit of God is living within us. Did you hear in this gospel? They will hand you over. They will have you scourged in their synagogues. You will be led before governors and kings for my sake, as a witness before them and the pagans, and they will hand you over. But don't worry about what you are to speak or what you are to say. You will be given at that moment what you are to say, for it will be not you who speak, but the Spirit of your Father speaking through you. That's much hope. And that's the solace that we take in as we allow the Spirit to come into us and to allow us to do what we need to do. Many people will say, how do you do all that? How do you do this and that? How do you be faithful? How do you go to Mass every day? It's the Spirit who is living and breathing in each of you to allow you to come to this moment. How come your faith is so strong? How come you believe in all of this? Because I've accepted the Spirit in my life. And I'm not worrying about what maybe the world is worrying about. I want to worry about my soul. And if I know, if I trust and not to be afraid, I will endure until the end. The angels of Christmas and of its preparation always tell us not to be afraid. And they tell that to us today and every day. Do not be worried or afraid. It's the Spirit of God living and breathing in us to do what we're called to do. And even to die little deaths each day, so that we can constantly turn our attention to God and to walk with Him and to trust that He will provide what we need to say, what we need to do, and the direction in which He is leading us to. May St. Stephen, the first martyr, help us in our daily martyrdom of turning from sin and turning to God as we celebrate the octave of Christmas, the birth of our Savior. Let us now reflect upon the Word of God and turn to Him who gives us grace to do what we're called to do as we place these petitions before the Lord with confidence and trust.
For the Holy Father and for the Church, through the intercession of St. Stephen, may we be firm witnesses to the Gospel. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For government leaders, may the Lord help them lead with justice, mercy, and love. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For those who are sick, may God grant them the power of redemptive suffering and the fullness of His healing power. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For those gathered here and for all those we love, may Christ help us live as His courageous disciples, speaking the truth and loving as He loves. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For those who have died, may God's mercy be upon them this day. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the sick and suffering, Stephen and Anita Savo, Desiree Cedric, Angelina Schneidinger, and all those on our prayer list, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
And for the intentions of the Nichols grandchildren for which this Mass is being offered, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
We also pray for the spiritual and temporal needs of St. Mary's Parish, so that all of us may further the mission of Jesus. Let us pray to the Lord. Let us also pray for an increase in vocations to the priesthood and consecrated life, especially from members of our own parish family. Let us pray to the Lord. Pretty gracious God, we place these petitions before you. If they're in accord with your holy will, we ask you to grant them through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
receive the bread we offer you, fruit of the earth and work of human hands, it will become for us the bread of life.
Blessed be God forever.
Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation, for through your goodness we have received the wine we offer you, fruit of the vine and work of human hands, it will become our spiritual drink.
Blessed be God forever.
Offering in every respect, make it spiritual and acceptable, so that it may become for us the body and blood of your most beloved Son, our Lord Jesus Christ. On the day before he was to suffer, he took bread in his holy and venerable hands. And with eyes raised to heaven to you, O God, his almighty Father, giving you thanks, he said the blessing, broke the bread, and gave it to his disciples, saying, take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you. Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours now and forever.
said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you. Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
Peace of the Lord be with all of you.
And with your spirit."
Lamb of God,
you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, grant us peace.
Behold the Lamb of God, behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those who are called to the supper of the Lamb.
Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word and my soul shall be healed. Thank you.
give thanks to you, O Lord, who save us through the nativity of your Son and gladden us with the celebration of the blessed martyr Stephen, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.